Welcome to the Blazor Charts tutorial. Here I'll demonstrate how to create a Syncfusion Blazor Line Series chart with real-time data. Additionally, I'll demonstrate how to customize features such as data labels, axis labels, titles, and more to enhance the chart's clarity and readability. Let me show you the steps to create a line chart in the Syncfusion Blazor Line Chart control. Before that, let's delve into a real-time scenario and example data. In the United States, from 2022 onwards, the avian influenza outbreak, known as bird flu, caused a significant 120% increase in egg prices. Now, I am going to populate the data track for egg price hikes from January to December of the same year using a line series chart to visually analyze the data. If you're interested in delving deeper into this real-time scenario and exploring the data for national average egg prices, please check the blog link provided in the description below. Although there are over 50-plus Syncfusion chart types available in Blazor for this real-time example data, it is indeed wise to use a line chart. This type of chart effectively visualizes trends and fluctuations over time. Now let me open an existing project in the auto mode of the Blazor web app. If you want to know how to create a Blazor web app and choose auto mode, check the video link to the above YouTube card. You can also find this example by following the link provided in the description below. In the Solution Explorer of the project, let me open the Program CS class. You'll notice the utilization of both server and WebAssembly render modes. Initially, the component is rendered from the server and the application simultaneously downloads the assemblies to the client. I navigate to the AppRaiser component, where the render mode is assigned as an interactive auto within the routes and head outlet component. Next, I will show you how to add the Syncfusion Blazor Charts component to a client project. First, I need to install the Syncfusion Blazor Charts NuGet package into my application. So, I open the NuGet Package Manager, switch to Browse tab, search for Syncfusion Blazor Charts package, and install the latest version. After installation, I navigate to the Imports Razor file within the client-side project and add the Syncfusion Blazor Charts namespace, allowing me to utilize the Blazor Chart component. Next, I open the server-side Program CS file and add the Syncfusion Blazor namespace. Then, I register the Syncfusion Blazor service. Afterward, I need to reference the script file in the application to work on the Blazor chart component. Therefore, navigate to the AppRaiser component and refer to the script file within the header tag. Now that everything is configured, let me proceed to add the Syncfusion Blazor chart. For that, I need to open the Home Razor component. Here, I define the Syncfusion Blazor Chart component by replacing the default code. Next, I'll show you how to add data to the Blazor chart and display it as a line series. To render a line series chart within the Home Razor component, I first need to define the Chart Series Collection tag, which is an array that can contain any number of chart series definitions. Since I'm planning to add a single line series chart, so I define a single chart series tag with the type property set to line to render the line series chart. Next, I'll prepare the data for the chart to provide the egg prices in a specific format. To do this, I create the egg price model class inside the class to hold the monthly data using the month and average price properties. To generate the collection of egg prices, I create an egg price list of type egg price model class. Within the list, I set the array of the month and average prices based on the surge in US egg prices. Next, I bind the egg price list object to the data source property and map the data source fields month to X name and average price to Y name properties of the chart series. Here, I'm going to use date-time value data in the x-axis. So first, I define a chart primary x-axis tag and set the value type property to date-time. Let me run the example application. You can see the line chart rendered with the provided data. Notice that the default label format around the x-axis is month. If you want to customize the label format to display date, year, or other formats, refer to the documentation link provided in the description below. Then observe that the average price values are on the y-axis. Next, I will show you how to customize the chart's appearance by changing the axis element's appearance, like showing data labels at the line points, changing the line style, adding data markers, and adding titles to the chart. First, I will show you how to set a title for the chart. I set the title property to average egg price surges within the Syncfusion Blazor chart code. Also, set the subtitle to the average price for a dozen grade A eggs in the US rose in 2022. As the x-axis denotes months, so I set the x-axis title as month. And for the y-axis, I define the chart primary y-axis tag and set the title as price USD as it represents price values in dollars. Look now, after setting the title and subtitle, the chart's height is decreased, prompting the adjustment of the y-axis based on the chart height. The main title is average egg price surges, x-axis title is month, and the y-axis displays price in dollars. Notice that the subtitle text overflows. However, when hovering over the subtitle, the entire subtitle is displayed. To customize the subtitle, define the chart subtitle style tag and set the text overflow as none. Now you can see the chart subtitle is clearly displayed. Next, I will show you how to customize the y-axis label. In this output, data values range from 0 to 5. Suppose I need to set a custom range for y-axis. Within the chart primary y-axis, I define two properties, minimum and maximum, with custom values from 0.5 to 5. Additionally, I need to add dollar symbol and y-axis average price, so I add the label format property to dollar. See here, the data values range from the minimum value is 0.5 to the maximum value is 5. Also notice that the data values rendered with dollar symbol. Next, I will show you how to customize the series. To change the series color, set the fill property to orange within the chart series tag. Additionally, to highlight the series, I set the dash array property to 10. Also set the width and opacity property for highlight the series. Look now, you can see the series with the specified color and dash array, effectively highlighting the series. Next, I will demonstrate how to add a marker and customize its appearance. To do this, I define the chart marker tag within the chart series tag and set the visible property to true. In this case, I require a circular shaped marker, so I set the shape property. There are four available shapes: circle, triangle, diamond, and rectangle. I select the circle shape. Additionally, I set the height and width of the circle. Furthermore, I define the chart marker border tag and set the width property to 2 and color to black. Look now, you can observe the marker with the provided customization. Next, let me proceed to show you how to add data labels to display information about the data points. To add data labels, first, I need to define a chart data label tag inside the chart marker tag. Then I set the visible property to true to display the data point information in the chart. Look now, you can see the line series chart displaying the data labels for every data point. Next, I will demonstrate how to change the color of the chart area. To do this, I define a chart area tag and set the background property to sky blue. Look now, you can see the chart area successfully rendered with the provided background color. Now, let me summarize what I covered in this video. I showed you how to add the Blazor chart component in a Blazor web app. Additionally, I showed how to enable and customize some features in line chart with real-time examples. If you would like to see the working code of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free community license to use all our Blazor products. If you find this video helpful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.